Good afternoon, everyone. Honorable Shri Amarjit Chopra ji, Chairman NACAS and Chairman of the current technical session, is one of the professional, and I have seen, you know, among all the three professional bodies, you know, his name is taken with a great pride and respect. And he has brought a lot of transformation, a lot of changes, and always, you know, people look at him as a front runners and bring a change in the profession. It is always an honor to be sit with him, rather. Shri Raju Saranji, Joint Controller General Account, Minister of Finance. Mr. Reddy, President, Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. Mr. Shah, Financial Commissioner, Railways. Mr. Salecha, Mr. Sushil Bahl, our government nominee. Mr. M.K. Mittal, one of our very senior members, and with the Director of Finance of the Dedicated Corridor. Mr. Banerjee from CONCON, and other senior members, Mr. B.B. Goyalji. And dear friends, we got an opportunity to listen to our Honorable Minister of Railway, Mr. Suresh Prabhu. The way he works, everybody understands his speed is more than the Gatiman Express. So the day he came into the power and the way he is given with the charge of the ministry, he was very clear in mission and vision, what he wants. So from the day one, he was very clear and he sent a very loud and signals very clear. We got a lot of opportunity under CI also to work with him in the sustainability and other performance awards in environmental. So luckily, you know, we were quite benefited with this past experience. So we were very sure that day we are going to work with this minister because he wants to go to the integrators. He wants a total transparency. He wants a governance. If you look at him and try to understand the minister thoroughly, in everything you will find him truly a cost and management accountant. Whatever he wants the basis, why it is being there, he wants, you know, why this thing is happening. He just don't need the data. He needs the analysis of the same. If you look at worldwide, today everybody is moving towards the integrated reporting. People are not just talking about the accounting. People wants, you know, what is important today is the integration. Whether it is a human capital, whether it is a social capital, what is the meaning coming out of it? There was used to be era when people talk only about the shareholders, but today people talking about the stakeholders, because society is one of the very biggest stakeholders. Today, whenever you're serving, it is very important what is the value you're creating. It is just not the recording of the data or coming out with the balance sheet or something, but what it is saying. So what finally the world realizes, you know, they're capturing the data, but what is missing is what is coming out of it. What are the analysis? What are the non-financial? Earlier, the entire people were considering more on the financial data. But today, if you look at any person, even the Honorable Minister was saying in the morning, and if you look at his forward, if you read his forward, it is clearly, he has written very clearly, mission beyond bookkeeping, enhancing transparency and accountability. So the idea is that, you know, whatever the financial statements are there, what it is conveying. So whatever the non-financial statement, that is taking a more of a meaning today. So in order to capture how we are getting at, is the right pricing, whether is the right cost center, where is the profit center. Even he mentioned, you know, it is a, even you talk about the human resource, it may not be the overstaffing. It may be possible in a particular department, there are more people and some other department is understaffed. So we have to categorically understand whether at the right cost center, the right cost is being booked or not. So until now, we are not able to do that, the pricing won't be the perfect. And today is the era of competition when our Honorable Finance Minister, he was saying, even the railways are getting a competition today. If you talk about the competition, today even, you know, when we were discussing, when Mr. Prabhu called us and we were discussing, so with the railways, we understand, you know, with the, for example, with the 500 kilometers, railway is getting a lot of competition because people are not using much of the railways when there is a short distance. But there is another mode of transportation which is getting more viable. So one has to really analyze from the data what to do on that sector, how to get into the competition. Even from the road, you're getting a lot of competition. So that is the thing now even the railways have to look into. And when our Honorable Finance Minister was talking about, he was very clear ki what is looking at towards accounting, costing and budgeting, a complete integrated solution. And that will take us to the digital India. So the moment when these three things come in totality, we can always look at the Digital India, and the, your data which is flowing, it is giving you a lot of meaning. So that's what people look at today. And they were very clear, they don't need any populism measures. It's just not a true and fair view. If they need, key one should certify, and that is the end of the game. That is the beginning of the things. So there the role of the cost and management accountant comes. But the world is looking at the management accounting today, and accounting is a subset of the same. If you look at the title of this national conference, Accounting Reforms in Indian Railways, a Strategic Mission, basically what Railway is trying to do, they want to use its operating financial and cost data to improve efficiency, productivity, cost competitiveness, profitability and sustainability. If you look at the worldwide, there are many countries who has adopted and implanted already the actuarial accounting. USA has adopted it, New Zealand has adopted it, Australia has done it, France has done it, Russia has done it. So there are many good examples of actuarial accounting. One can learn from that. There are already the experiences which is on the readily available. But if you look at, now the real challenge comes in the performance accounting. That is going to be happen for the very first time in the entire world. Indian Railways of such a size, nobody is in the world has tried this. So the role of our institute, the Institute of Cost Accountants of India, is very, very critical and very crucial. And we are very thankful to the Honorable Minister. He has posed so much of faith on our institution. And I'm sure with so much such an experience, we have Mr. Mittal, Mr. Banerjee, our so many members at the helm of the affairs who has got such a decades of experience. So we are very sure we are going to come out with the best of the product. Though there is some, even if you talk about the Department of Post, they try to implement activity-based costing. Though they try to work it out scientifically, but somewhat it has not yet been fully implemented. Even the defense, they try it, their defense procurement board, they try to implement full life cycle costing, which is really working good for their strategic procurements. I remember when our team and our past presidents and our people, they met Shri Sanjay Mukherjee, former Financial Commissioner of Railways, and other very senior officers of the railways. And there's a long meetings and how to come with the vision and what are the steps for actuarial accounting, performance costing and outcome budgeting in Indian Railways. There are a series of meetings which went with the Chartered Accountant Institute and our institute also. And finally, it was being realized, you know, this is the exercise which has to be taken. And then we have given a lot of presentation to the people. Even the Honorable Minister met us many times. He understood and he has given us very clarity what he has in mind. So finally, in the performance-based costing, what did emerge out? What are the financial factors need to be considered? What are the non-financial parameters that need to be considered? What are the factors which need to be captured, which is beyond and more accurate, the cost information should be there. So what is finally coming out is we need to identify the areas which are giving the value creation areas and critical success factors. And linking these areas with the value creation with the respective cost and giving the success factors. If you look at the, normally it is known as the activity-based costing also. And a lot of private sector, government sector, public sector has tried to implement the same. So I'm sure, you know, once, you know, any organization is able to build up the process on the resources, activities, outputs, and the outcomes, the real product will come out with it. And if we look at the different activities which has been formulated, what is the necessity and how it will be coming, finally the outcome would be coming in the form of taking the correct business decisions, reliable costs, reduced costs, improved efficiency, cost competitiveness, profitability and sustainability. And definitely what will finally it will result into, the customer will be benefited, the society will be benefited, they'll be getting the right product at the right price. Today, when you're spending a money, you need a value addition, a value creation out of it. The moment a customer feels he's paying for the right product and the right pricing, and why this is missing today? Because the basis of allocation and apportionment is not so scientific today. So the moment this study is being undertaken and the moment our results are going to come out of it, so there will be scientific basis, there will be cost accounting manual, there will be cost, a lot of value creation will be coming out. Because a lot of, over a period of time, a lot of data would be there, but now we'll be getting deeper into that. We'll be studying that data, and a lot of meaningful comparison and brainstorming will be coming out of it. And I'm really honored, you know, that we have just been allotted this work by the railways, and now an entire team of our institute is being geared up. And I'm very sure with Salisha, he has made us very clear. He and his minister is very clear. The deadline has to be met. And I like to assure the entire railways and the honorable minister that we are very much geared up and our team is very much competitive, and you know, we are the right people, and you have posed faith on us. We won't let you down, and definitely we are going to come out with a very good product. And 2019 has been set up the deadline to make it truly integrated and to all the three sectors. Much before that, we'll be coming out with a very good product. And I'm sure that Mr. Reddy, he'll be helping us in accounting, because the data will be flowing from that. We'll be analyzing and taking a meaning analysis out of that. So they have already done their part, but definitely we need a lot of their expertise and help also. And at the end, I'm really grateful to Mr. Shah, Financial Commissioner, and Mr. Mohapatra, Additional Member of Finance, for providing their valuable guidance and support. And in the entire mission, the role played by Shri Naresh Salecha ji, Shri Satyendra Kaushik ji, Venkateshwar ji, and Madam Abhilasha is highly laudable. I could see, you know, every time I could see the mission, the way Madam Abhilasha is working on it, it's really commendable. And my special thanks to the Honorable Minister for posing such a, and giving us such an opportunity. Thank you.